cautery of a what? It's being now told that the virus load, the next one, the cautery, the viral load is seen around the what? What's being told is, see, you cauterize a what? That's not enough. Cauterize the surrounding area, you won't get recurrence. Just cauterizing the what? Definitely there will be a recurrence. Nowadays, beauty parlor, they are earning in and around 30,000 to 40,000 rupees per day. We all should earn like that. I am earning, you should earn. That's the basic objective of all these things. They do without a medical knowledge, we will do with the medical knowledge. Anyway, both are going to be recurrent, nothing is going to be curative. Temporary arrest. On the face, the joules is to be less than 5 to, it can be in and around 5 to 6. Don't cure it any what? Don't cure it any seborrheic keratosis. Don't cure it any molluscum contagiosum after burning. Leave everything out. That would be very nice. This is a case of alopecia areata. Our associate professor, Dr. Sambath, has done a trial. His thesis is cryosurgery. In alopecia areata, he has tried cryosurgery. Alopecia areata, as such, if at all you leave it also, it will definitely grow. Depends upon the immunity. But, again, way of making money, you can just use a cryo. We are going to use a cryo. It will cost 1,000 rupees. You will definitely have a good hair growth. Yes. Even otherwise, it's going to grow. Small methylprednisolone on 4 milligram on alternatives will definitely give good results. But just methylprednisolone in a prescription will fetch you only 100 rupees. This will fetch you 1,500 rupees. So you can do a cryo for alopecia areata also. Normally I don't use cryo, sir, for anything, because the most sensitive organelle in the body is melanocyte. At -2 to -4, below -20, every melanocyte is gone. So we should not end up with hypopigmentation or depigmentation later on. So cryo for a what? Cryo for seborrheic keratosis, please don't do. Please don't do. One day or other, you will end up with depigmentation, end up with problems. Going for a cauterization, that will be very nice. That will be very, very safe. I use cryo only for keloid. Other than keloid, I don't advise in anything. Because these things we ask our technicians or we ask our nurses to do it, definitely we will end up with problems. Even though we do, we also will end up with problems. So, going for cautery for seborrheic keratosis, for anything. For keloid and plantar what? Going for cryo. Don't think about the pain from the patient side. Think about the cure from the patient side. And patient should not come and ask us anything after the procedure. Now we are going in for nail surgery. This is an ingrowing toenail. I think you are able to see that ingrowing toenail there. I am going to give a ring block. This is without adrenaline. I told you the 2-3 areas where you should not give adrenaline along with the xylocaine for block. One is genitals. Two is these fingers. Third one, in the mucosa. In all other areas, we can mix adrenaline. Have an emergency tray always whenever you start a surgery. Whenever you start a surgery, because even a small cautery produces a shock. Have adrenaline with you always. Ingrowing toenail, we can go in for a partial nail avulsion or a full nail avulsion. Partial nail avulsion, if at all you want to do, just cut the nail and then go in for avulsion. Otherwise, if at all you want to have a full nail avulsion, we can just go in for a full removal. I am now going in for a full nailed aversion. And any question from the audience side, please go on, sir. Once you go out of this session, immediately you have to start your own center. You have to be bold enough. I told you there will be lots of obstacles, right? So once you start these things in your institution, you will get up problems. But don't worry, our objective should be very, very clear, without problems. See this? See what I am doing? This is a full nail aversion. See how I am going around. Only thing, there will be recurrence after this surgery in all ingrowing toenails. What we can do is, if we can destroy the matrix on the side where it grows, or we can use a dental floss. The dental floss is a small thread. Once the nail starts to regrow, what you can do is, you can put that dental floss, that will be a small wire, something like your suture. What you can do is, even without surgery, if you can put this floss, consider this as a floss, just in between that, this nail will grow straight. This you can get in all dental department, it's a dental floss. Even after surgery, to avoid recurrence, if at all you are not going to burn out the matrix. Right? When this nail starts to grow, put this floss for 3-4 days, everything will become normal. Catch out of the nail, just spin out, finished. See that ingrowing toenail there, the one which has grown there, two areas, one, two, right? Just close it. While it again regrows, we can use a dental floss to see that it does not come again. This is to just burn the matrix on the area where it regrows like that, where we expect. Just this is TCA, trichloroacetic acid 30%. You can just burn the matrix. It turns brown in color. Once it turns brown in color, wash it out. It turns brown in color. Say you remove a sebaceous cyst. After that also, you have to do this. See the turning of that color. This is a chemical cauterization of the matrix. See that brown color now? After that, you can wash and go in for a dressing. Otherwise, you can cauterize also. I used to cauterize that area. That also gives good results. Simple technique. If you want to preserve half of the nail, while you do the procedure itself, you can cut the half nail and then go in for that. Next, we go in for hair transplantation. Choosing of patients. Patients, one, affordability for the medical treatment to continue, because surgery alone is not going to solve the problem. Surgery, we may implant around 500 to 600 hair roots. It's not at all going to be enough. Second one, the medical treatment, it will cost around 1,500 to 2,000 rupees per month. It has to be continued for at least a period of 2 years. You start finasteride, 1 to 2 milligram per day. What is advised is 1 milligram. What we see is 2 milligram gives very good results daily. After starting finasteride, after 6 weeks, go in for surgery. After that, continue the drugs for 2 years. If not 2 years, the results are not going to be good. The results are not going to be good. So be careful about the patient selection. You select the patient,